told something that sounds so good you just believe it. I mean, you're not even gonna question it. Why would you? It sounds that good. You hear it, you like it, or you don't like it. It really doesn't matter because you're not gonna look into it anyways. Look, I'm sure the person that told you this thing didn't mean to lie to you. They probably heard it a bunch of times and then they told you. And you probably heard something like that a bunch of times in the past. So I guess that's the secret of questioning the truth, right? A bunch of times plus a bunch of times equals truth. Kinda like what you heard your mom say. Don't swallow your gum because in 7 years you're gonna pass it through your digestive system. Although she probably didn't say the word digestive system. She probably said something like, poop it out. Or boo-boo it out. Or caca. Or whatever else cutesy word she came up with to describe that nasty, disgusting part of our lives.
Ah, but everybody poops.
Yeah, everybody's disgusting. Back to the myth. 7 years? Seven? 7 years is a long time. That makes the gum that I accidentally swallowed when I was in sixth grade. A senior in high school? It doesn't take 7 years. A couple of days, maybe. 2 to 3 tops. But 7 years? The truth is, your stomach acids didn't break down your gum, which means your gum is gonna look the same way coming out as it did going in. But 7 years? How about this one? If you shave your facial hair, it'll grow back thicker. Parents usually tell the little boys this in the midst of puberty. Parents don't want their little boys to shave, because if they shave, then they're one step closer to being a man. So instead of admitting that their little boy's growing up, they'd rather walk around with patches of thin, colorless hair in his face. As if middle school isn't hard enough, now they gotta walk around looking like a predator creep with a 5 o'clock shadow. The truth is, shaving has absolutely nothing to do with the roots. And if it has absolutely nothing to do with the roots, then it has absolutely nothing to do with growth. If that were the case, then why aren't guys who are going bald shaving their heads to reverse the process? Oh, here's why. It doesn't work. But this isn't just something that happens when you're a little kid. Politicians and news organizations use this tactic all the time. They say things over and over and over again until you believe it. And the crazy thing is, you usually do. For example, when they're talking about things like immigration, they say, we need to build a fence because immigrants are jumping over the border.
No. Most immigrants come with legal visas. And to say that immigrants are jumping the border is factually incorrect and actually a little racist.
And since we're on this, let's talk about another myth. Immigrants are Mexican.
No. Most immigrants are Asian and Latin American. And yeah, Mexicans are Latin American. But have you ever seen Latin America?
It's a huge piece of land. There's Mexico, Central America, and South America. It's a ridiculous piece of land. Just because they speak the same language doesn't make them all Mexican. I don't go around calling Irish immigrants Canadian just because they speak the same language. And since we're on this topic, why don't you take that fence and stick it on the Canadian border? It's a way bigger border, and it can protect us from people like Justin Bieber. Here's another one. Immigrants are illegal. No. Some immigrants are undocumented. No immigrant is illegal because no human being can be illegal. And I'm not just saying this because I'm some kind of champion for political correctness. I'm saying this because it's factually incorrect. So I'm driving down the street the other day and I'm going like 5 miles over the speed limit. Alright, so I'm going like 10 miles over the speed limit, which is illegal. But that doesn't make me illegal. It makes what I did illegal. I'm perfectly legal. Some people like to smoke crack. Crack is illegal. Smoking crack, illegal. But that doesn't make them illegal. It makes them drug addicts. Here's another one. Undocumented immigrants don't pay taxes. Not true. Undocumented immigrants pay billions of dollars in taxes a year, and usually for benefits they're not gonna receive in the future anyway. Immigrants pay sales tax, immigrants contribute to property taxes, and since most undocumented workers use false identification to get a job anyway, federal income taxes, state income taxes, social security taxes, and Medicare taxes are taken out of their checks automatically. Oh, and if they're ineligible, then they must be poor, and if they're poor, then there must be crime, hence immigrant equals high crime. No, it's another myth. Actually, there was this report done by the Conservative American Majority Foundation. They found that crime rates were at its lowest in states with the highest immigration growth rates. The fact is, immigrants are less likely to be behind bars than native-born Americans.
Well, that's not what I see on my television shows, or see on my movies, or hear on the radios.
Oh, so you believe in the oversimplified generalization of an entire group of people that are usually brown. Alright, here's the last one, Immigration is a political issue. No, first and foremost, immigration is a moral issue. If a person is living in abject poverty and seeks access to a wealthier nation, it is that nation's
nation's moral obligation to assist that person. If a person is trying to escape persecution or death, it is that same nation's moral obligation to protect that person. It's about respect of human dignity. And then all the political stuff.